Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So I already raised my Kuro to level 70 and she is now having 10k power as you can see here, and her Hashrate is now more than 1800 Hashrate. Yep, to be exact 1824 Hashrate in total. The reason why I can reach that kind of high Hashrate is because of this. I'm using the 12%, 12%, and 12%. I already tested it, and actually the one with percentage like this gives higher Hashrate boost compared to the one that gives 54 Hashrate like this one. Yeah, and also try to get the substats with Hashrate percentage like this, 2.1%, which is nice. This one also have 2.1%. This one also have 1.4% Hashrate boost. Yeah, the physical penetration is probably not really needed for Kuro, but yeah, somehow it still can boost the normal attack damage, so okay. And yeah, try to get more Hashrate substats on the other algorithms, which can actually boost her damage like even higher. The reason why I said 1800 is high because many other Kuro friends didn't have 1800 Hashrate, as you can see here, only 1600. This one also 1699. This one too, not even 1700. This one too, 1737. 1648. 1500. So that's why I said 1800 is pretty high. Okay, so last time when I did the 10k damage per hit using her skill, I did it on this Endless Exploration Chapter 5 on the floor 100. So I will do the same. Yeah, I will test my Kuro here. I just want to see how high the damage of this level 70 Kuro with 10k power. Also, I want to bring a Delacey. Yeah, somehow she's a new character and she's a very good support in my opinion. As you can see here, Delacey can enhance the ally's Hashrate by 40% and also heal. Yeah, but the thing that I want to get from Delacey is this, the Hashrate plus 40% buff. So I'm just going to bring this one. Honestly, it is quite hard to find a Delacey friend with max level like this. Yeah, not many of them actually raise their Delacey yet probably. So maybe we can try to use only 1 DPS this time, only Kuro. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the one that Delacey will buff in this kind of party will be my Kuro. So let's give it a try. Okay, I will get this one of course, Brainstorm, Hashrate plus 30%. And I will get this one. When medic heal, they increase the Hashrate of ally units by themselves by 5% for 4 seconds up to 5 stacks, so up to 20%. And I will get these buffs. Yep, I want this set. Structural Embrittlement and the Freezing Bullets. Okay, Sharpshooter, 50% damage. Okay, it's a first layer's boss. By far, the protocols are Brainstorm and Sharpshooter. The Structural Embrittlement 2 set and the Freezing Bullet 2 set. Not completed yet, but I think we can already see Kuro's damage. Let's do it in one speed. Around 4000 damage per hit. Okay. Yeah, not bad. But still far from the one that I'm looking for. Okay, the final set of Structural Embrittlement. Yep, this is it. 10% Hashrate boost for snipers up to 10 stacks. So 100% Hashrate boost in total. Okay, obtain protocol Dragon Slayer. So I have to put Delacey on the same row as my Kuro so that my Kuro can get her buff like this. Ugh, it's already 9000 damage per hit from Kuro. Okay, I think it is because of the full set of Structural Embrittlement just now. Okay, let's try again, still with one speed. Come on Kuro, use your skill. There you go. 9600 already. 10,000. Wow. Already 10,000 damage with only 2 Hashrate protocols. That's cool. Okay, here we go. Heavy firepower. The last piece of the Hashrate protocol. Okay, I think I can get the last piece of this freezing bullet using overclock. Yep, this is it. So, As for now, I think I already have all of the buffs that I need for Kuro. This protocol, Brainstorm, Hashrate plus 30%, this one, long range unit deal 50% more damage, and this one, Hashrate plus 50%, and this structural embrittlement basically can give up to 100% Hashrate. This freezing bullets can give her up to 50% Hashrate boost. So let's see her damage. Yeah, let's just enjoy her damage. No ultimate yet. Come on, Kuro. Oh, skill. Okay, 11,000. Skill again. Okay, 11,000 damage by far. We still have one more layer to see Kuro's damage. So yeah, we can enjoy the damage for one whole layer. Go, Kuro. There you go. Where is the damage? Twelve thousand damage that I saw just now. Okay, let's do it again. Come on, Kuro. Use your skill. There you go. 12,000. 10,000. Come on, Kuro. The skill. 10,000. Use again. Is that it? 12,000 damage is the highest that I saw until now. Let's try again. Thirteen thousand. You can see it right there. 13,214 damage. Okay. That's a nice image. Let's upgrade this one. Everything for Kuro. Look at all of these yellow sniper buffs. Everything is for Kuro. 3 healers, 1 tank, 1 sniper party. Unusual party. 15,000 damage. 16,000, what is that? Okay. Oh, the Danmaku actually, yeah, did the most damage this time. Okay, let's fight this one. Come on, Kuro. Use your skill. Kuro. What? 16,000. Okay. 16,000 damage. I think I saw 20k damage just now, but not really sure. Okay, Kuro, do it again. Give me your best shot. 12,000. 16,000 just now. Use again, Kuro. Yeah, 12,900. Yeah, I think I saw 16,000 damage just now. Okay, here we go. So, this is the final buff, and this is actually the last boss on the third layer, last battle. Yeah, still the same protocols, and still the same 4 set of structural embrittlement, 4 set of freezing bullets, and here is a new one, full set of coordinated critical. The next normal attack ally units perform after using any skill is guaranteed to be a critical hit, including Kuro's. Will recover HP of 10% damage dealt when a landing critical hit. So yeah, this is a really nice buff for Kuro. Okay, so let's see Kuro's damage. Come on. $11,000, $15,000, $14,000, $12,000. Yeah. I think the damage increase compared to her level 60 and without Delacey is somewhere around 3,000 to 6,000 damage. Yeah, 30% to 60% damage boost in total. Just one single DPS in this party. Three healers. Kinda new. So yeah, that's the level 70 Kuro showcase. And to be honest, I'm not finished yet with my Kuro algorithm build because I'm still looking for a better spatial algorithm. Okay, so I think that's all guys for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and yeah, still waiting for Hatsuchiri basically. As for now, while waiting for Hatsuchiri, don't forget to raise your characters to level 70. Yeah, keep grinding those materials. So thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you next time. Bye, Ushi Punch.